single biggest challenge humanity is facing is climate change. Our deep and profound passion is to create a world that runs entirely on green energy. We create renewable energy through wind farms, and we believe technology is vital for the transition of the world's energy systems. In terms of the intelligence that can optimize the performance of the individual wind turbine or the total energy system, including the transmission and the effectiveness of the entire system, but it's also for the ability for us to foster teamwork and bring out the ingenuity of employees and partners all over the world. Well, I believe that Orsted and Microsoft are great partners because we both have a vision to change the world. The ingenuity of companies together with the determination of leaders will make us land with a planet that we are proud to hand over to the future generations.
I'm here with Michael in Anholt, Denmark, and we have been superimposed here virtually on one of the world's largest wind farms. Before we get started, Michael, I just have to congratulate you and the entire Orsted team. You've been ranked the world's most sustainable energy company in the Global 100 Index 3 times in a row now, and I'm really excited that we're able to partner with you here at Microsoft. I'd love it if you could start off by talking about how cloud is empowering your goals.
Orsted's growth is still ahead of us, so a lot of incredible stuff will be built in the next 10 years to come. But in parts of the world, with seas and winds and technologies that we barely know yet, that requires that we do lots of simulations based on data. So with the transition to parallel compute and the utilization of the cloud, we've been able to speed up these simulations quite a lot. So you get usable results in just a short time of maybe 4 hours. In the old days, it took days, weeks, even months. When these wind farms then go into operations, you know, we've gone past the milestone of 1,500 turbines out there. So they produce, you know, huge amounts of data every second, every minute, every hour, every day. Data is not just an asset. You need to sort through it, you need to clean it, you need to store it properly, you need to rationalize it to actually make it usable for the things that we're trying to accomplish.
That's awesome, Michael. And it's super clear that Orsted has become really a fantastic powerhouse for clean energy. But you've also become quite an impressive technology company in your own right. And you have many elite developers that work on the technology landscape that empowers Orsted. So I'd like to switch gears a little bit to that end and talk about how you're actually empowering that developer core.
We are all in on Azure DevOps. So all developers, you know, they draw on the same set of tooling to make sure that our data estate is used to the best of our ability. And once the lockdown hit us in March 2020, we made a jump to Teams quite seamlessly and very quickly, making it just that little bit easier to cooperate across the globe, but also just with your next door neighbor that you cannot see at your workplace anymore. It's facilitating daily scrums and even the big PI planning sessions for the next sprints to come. Teams and the Azure DevOps, it will be utilized in the years to come.
That's awesome. I often say that none of us is as smart as all of us, right? And if you can create the collaborative fabric where you can bring great minds together and aggregate their thoughts, there's no question that you can produce better results. We've kind of let you in on many of the announcements that we've been making here at Ignite. And I'm wondering if through that disclosure process, there was anything that really caught your eye.
The one that excites me the most personally, I think, which is the possibility of incorporating machine learning. I strongly believe that in the next few years to come, we will actually see the large-scale adoption of machine learning for a lot of things that we do. And it will play a crucial part, you know, in the further advancement of everything that we do and make us even more competitive and, of course, turn the world into a place that runs entirely on green energy. You know, augmenting human intelligence and ingenuity with machines is something that will really be crucial.
That's fantastic, Michael. Well, listen, thank you so much for spending some time with me. Certainly over this last year, the pandemic has really taken center stage in terms of the biggest challenge the world's working on collectively. But shortly thereafter, I think we will return to really, truly the planet's number one problem, and that is sustainability. And you are all leading in that regard, and we can't thank you enough for your efforts.